Hi guys, Caitlin here. I'm here with my roommate, Lola. She lives in our living room. Lola was adopted from a Sears, rescued. She was rescued from a Sears in Ontario that was going out of business. My mom carried her through the mall and then across the border and brought her to New York. And she's been with me longer than my husband has. So we're here and we are ready to watch some Olympics. I get Olympic fever like you wouldn't believe. February, super bananas. We went on vacation. We had to go away for work. We were super busy at work with super long hours. So instead of a regular update, I'm putting together a Stitch Mania Olympic event vlog. And we'll go back to regular updates next month. Super loud upstairs, as usual. Anyway, I hope you enjoy it, and I look forward to seeing all the stuff you guys worked on during the Olympic challenge, and I look forward to some gold medals. So, go Canada. Sorry, USA. I don't cheer for the USA when the Olympics are on. It's all about the homeland. Anyway, see you later. So it's about 1 o'clock in the morning on Saturday. Just got home from work Friday night, and I am getting ready to do... Oh, the cats are getting ready to play. Excuse me. Scratching my couch. I'm getting ready to stitch a little on the first Stitch Mania's Olympic event, which is a new or recent start, and I'm going to stitch on Maple Sugar, which is one, if not my newest start, one of my more recent starts. So this is being stitched on, I believe, 32 count Silkweaver fabric Lugana in the colorway Sudden Storm. And this is all I have so far. Got my needle minder here that Dawn Frosty X Stitch sent me. We are watching reruns of the opening ceremonies. There you'll see Lola. She is, Lola was rescued from Canadian Sears by my mom. It closed down and Lola was about to be homeless. So my mom picked her up, adopted her, and brought her home to me. So she's all decked out in her patriotic attire. We're gonna try and get a few stitches in, try and catch the rest of the Parade of Nations. We'll see how we do. You know, I gotta say, NBC Olympic coverage, really awful. It's nothing like CBC Olympic coverage, that's for sure. All right, anyway, that's enough complaining. And, yeah. We'll see what I get done tonight, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. So it's about 11:45 on Saturday night. I decided to use maple sugar also for the second day for something winter themed, because it is a winter scene. And in 24 hours, I've managed just about 300 stitches, which a little disappointing. The day got away from me a little bit, and I was way too tired last night to do more than a couple stitches. So this is how far I've got, and I think I'm gonna call it a night and put it away, and I'll circle back to this later on in the Olympic challenge. It'll fit into a couple more days, but you know, I got
Got a little work done. This pattern, by the way, I think I've been saying it's a DMC pattern, but it's not. The pattern is from Heart of the Country, which I think no longer makes cross-stitch patterns, because I can't really find anything else by them on eBay, but that's the designer information.
Yeah, I'm showing you a corner of the chart, but anyway, if you're looking for it, because a couple people have asked, that's all the information I have. I got this pattern at a Goodwill when we were on vacation in July, and it was partially started. There was no cover with the pattern, just the little picture and her working copy and what I presume was the original copy. I'm gonna go upstairs and fall asleep in front of figure skating, and I will see you guys bright and early tomorrow. It's a hockey game on at 7 a.m. I want to catch before I get into the nitty-gritty of what I have to do tomorrow. A lot of errands to run, so anyway. So it's about 8 o'clock in the morning on Saturday. My radiators are going crazy, if you can hear that. And I'm working on my parlor treats for the third day. Theme for today is something related to Korea, and I have a soda stitch design, but I am really hoping to finish this one this month, and since it's got a lot of red and white and blue in it, I thought it would be a good choice. So this is what it's going to look like finished. And this is kind of where I'm starting from. And I'm hoping to get a lot done on this top part today. Watching some Ladies Moguls with Lola. And yeah. Good morning. It is Monday. It's about 8:30 in the morning, and this is where I got to last night, yesterday on parlor treats. I got about 200 stitches in, got a lot done. I got the straw, I filled in all the ice cream here. As you can see, I'm almost finished with this. We are leaving in about an hour, hour and a half to go to the airport because we're going on vacation, and I'm going to take this with me and try and finish filling in the missing stitches here and try and get the back stitching done while I'm on vacation. I thought it would be a good back stitching would be a good airport airport thing. So looking forward to finishing this up. It finally looks like an ice cream or a milkshake rather, instead of just some brown blobs. For a long time it just looked like brown stripes. So today the prompt is stitch on something animal related, so I haven't quite figured out what that's going to be, but I have a couple animal projects packed, and I'll show you what I worked on later. So I hope you can hear me okay. I'm in the air on our way to the Caribbean, and I'm working on Kathy Barrick's, oh my gosh, I'm showing the chart. Was embarrassing. Oops. I'm working on Kathy Barrick's Cat and Mouse. I've mostly been working on this cloud right here. So, yeah. For the animal component of the stitch along. Thank you.
yesterday. I didn't get a whole lot done because we arrived kind of late, and then it was the first day of Carnival, which I'll insert some videos of here. So today the prompt is to work on something for like a set time limit. It's a little after, it's almost 11 o'clock here. It's 10:45, so I'm going to settle into the couch and try and get as much done as I can between now and midnight, at which point I should probably get some rest because I'm pretty wiped from a crazy day of beaching. Anyway, I'll check in with you guys in an hour. So this is what I managed to get done in about an hour. I filled in some blue here, worked down here, worked down here, finished this cloud, did this cloud. Not that impressive. I really, I thought I was going to get more stitching done on this trip, but I guess I'm just going to be too busy having fun. So tomorrow we're going to hike on the side of the island that's a little more like jungle, see some wildlife, maybe see a volcano, try and find a black sand beach. We have a full day for tomorrow, so I'm going to try and get up a little earlier than everyone else to get some stitches into something, but, you know, I guess there's always plenty of time in the airport to get a lot more done down here. So, that's where I'm at. Good morning. Wednesday. Just wanted to show you our view. This is why I haven't really been stitching a whole lot. I've been beaching. Today I'm going to try and work a little on this new hand kit for Game Santa. For the prompt, the prompt for today is something with beads and metallics, so I'm going to try and work on this guy. Thought it would be a nice memory of the trip. I got a little stitching on him done while I was here. But, right now I'm going down to the beach. So I will see you guys tonight. So all I got done today was these six stitches. And I hate the way they look. I don't hold the three strands. I think it looks awful. So I think I spent most of the time working on this trying to find the center of the paper and then trying to figure out if I was on the right side, or I was just struggling tonight. So I'm gonna put this away and come back to it at a later date. Probably pull that out and redo it with two strands, because three strands just is so messy looking. Definitely overthinking it because I'm tired, but anyway, that's what I did. It's our last day of vacation. I started my morning by filling in a little here and here. Just took about 10 minutes to do that. So close to done on this. We'll definitely finish it on the plane ride home. Right now, I'm going to take a break, go down and make the most of the beach. Prompt for today for the Olympics challenge is stitch on two things. So, stitched on one, stitch on cat and mouse probably this evening. So, the sun is setting on our last day of vacation. Beach. We spent the whole day at the beach. It was so nice. Now I'm back up in our little balcony area, which, by the way, is an outdoor bathtub, which I never got around to trying. But, you know, how cool is that? And I'm working on parlor treats again. Just doing some more filling in here, trying to finish all the cross stitching today. I know I'm supposed to work on a second project for the Olympics event, so I don't know. I'll see what I can get done on this before we go to dinner, and maybe I'll pick up something else. But I really feel like this is so close to being done that I should just ignore this Stitch Mania event and just really, got really very little left to do cross stitching wise. And then, you know, back stitching always takes forever, but I could at least get it started tonight. This is a Year of Whips project, but this is one half of a Year of Whips project. It has a companion piece that I also need to do this year, so I should really just complete it. But I wanted to show you guys. I bought, while I was here on vacation, a bag I'm going to use as a project bag. So it's in this like traditional Madras print, which is like a really interesting fabric with a long history. I'll put a link below to like the Wikipedia information about it. There's the back. It has handles. This is probably meant to be like a lunch bag, not a cross-stitching project bag, but I saw it in a stand a few days ago when I was thinking about it, and then I went back and bought it today. So, you know, it's handmade, it's well-made, and it has, like, a loop on it. And it fits, it does fit my small Q-snap. I don't know if it would fit my 11 by 11, but it fits my 8 by 8. And it has this other little pouch attached inside of it, and it's good for like thread and notions, so that's great. Plus a little side pocket here, so I'm pretty thrilled about that. It's an upgrade from what I only own two other project bags, and so mostly what I use are these reusable plastic zipper bags that you get when you buy clothing off Amazon. Like, I ordered a new swimsuit, and it came in this bag, and I was like, oh, this is a perfect thing to carry my needles and extra bobbins in when I travel. So, this is usually almost all of my project bags, air quotes, are Ziploc bags or from something I ordered. You know, were the packaging for something I ordered from Amazon, because we order everything from Amazon. So, I just wanted to show you. I'm like really, really jazzed about this. I thought about buying some of this Madras fabric. They had it in several different colors. I almost did. It was about like 10 euros a meter. I don't know if that's a good deal or not. But I don't sew, and I don't quilt. I hope to learn to someday, but I don't right now. And I didn't really have like a plan in mind. So I thought, you know, I knew if I bought the fabric that it would just sit in my apartment for 3 years until I got the guts to use it for something, and it would be like too special to use, right? So I decided if I purchased something already made in the pretty fabric, I would get more immediate joy and use out of it, and maybe someday I can go back and come back here and get myself some pretty Madras fabric. I know I can order it on Etsy and eBay too, but I fully intend to come back here. This has been the best vacation I've ever had in my entire life. It was really great. I'm so glad we did it. So, if I can move here tomorrow, I would. Potential long-term goal, open cross-stitch store in Guadeloupe, because I didn't see any LNSs here. At least in the town we were staying in. So, potential retirement goal. Anyway, I have a lot of work to do. So, I will talk to you tomorrow or maybe later tonight. We'll see. Hey guys, it's Saturday morning and I'm excited to show you my finish. So, I finished the first parlor treats pattern. This is a Year of Whips project, but I said I was going to count both patterns as one whip to make sure I finish them as a set. So
I haven't started the second one yet, but this one's done. I did most of the back stitching yesterday on the plane. We flew back Friday afternoon. And I think it looks great. I'm really happy with how the glass turned out. Back stitching made a huge difference. I maybe wish that the back stitching on the ice cream was like a slightly darker color to really bring out, no, don't sit on that. So we have a slightly darker, so it would be like more contrast, but overall I'm really happy with how it looks. It's really cute. And I can't wait to hang it on my wall. I also realized that I screwed up the days. Thursday I was supposed to work on something Halloween themed, which I didn't do. I just worked on this guy instead. And so yesterday, Friday, was the day I was supposed to work on two projects, and I did do that. I finished this one, as I said, and then I also worked on the birds and the bees by Ink Circles, which I'm stitching 1/2 on 40 count, picture this plus barn wood, using a Dinky Dye silk in the color Threadbow. And I'm really pleased with how it's looking, although it is, it is hard to stitch on 40 count fabric, and it is hard to stitch on dark 40 count fabric, but I'm really happy with how it's turning out. So today's prompt is to do something with specialty stitches. I do have one project that involves specialty stitches, but it's not on my goal list for projects to work on for February. I set some stitch count goals for some of my Year of Whips projects for February, and it's not on the list, so I don't know if I will work on it or not. But if I am going to work a little more on this today, and this uses specialty floss, so I think that counts, right? Because it's a specialty fiber, not specialty stitches. But in any case, I'm going to do a little more on birds and the bees, and might see you guys again soon. And if not, I'll see you tomorrow. Good morning. It's Sunday morning. I'm up early watching hockey. Working on my Haid. The prompt for today is something related to heaven and earth. So obviously I'm going to work on a heaven and earth design. I'm just going to try and work down this column here a little bit. Maybe this column also. We'll see. Anyway. It's a Monday night. President's Day. Enjoyed the day off today. And I worked on my heaven and earth design again. Prompt for today was something related to 15. There are 15 colors in this design. So between, I don't know, when did I see you last? Was it Saturday? And tonight, I did about... Anyway, since I last picked this up, I've done about 900 stitches. In this part here, there's not that many colors, so it's gone really fast. So that's what I've been working on. So I'm pretty close to hitting my 1,200 stitches for Full Coverage Fanatics. I'm about... I got a cat here. Say hi! Another cat there. Lola and I are waiting for figure skating to come on. I'm pretty close to this is my bullet journal. It's where I keep track of my stitch count. These are the projects I want to stitch on this month, and each square represents 10 stitches, and that's what I want to complete on them. And another goal I had was to stitch every day. Finish something, did that. Stitch from stash in the black, currently in the black. And to complete all my number goals. So I have 280 stitches left to do on my heaven and earth design before I reach the 1,200 required stitches. And now I'm going to take a break and I'm going to move on to Gingerbread Cat and try and get 100 stitches in before I go to bed. Almost out of days in the month to get some work in on that. I really wanted to get a little bit done on that this month. So pretty happy with my progress, and so it is Tuesday the 20th. the hockey game to start. Getting a view of my cat hair fill, the ottoman. Just got home from work. It's a long day. Prompt for today is something with a house. This is my gingerbread cat project. I'll see if I can insert a picture here of what it's going to look like. It does have a little gingerbread house in it. As you can see, I'm very far along. I had started this one over one, and I realized last night, I had started this one over two, pardon, and I realized last night, although I prefer the one over two, because this looks a little, I think this is 32 count, it looks a little jammed, in my opinion. But it turns out, after a closer examination of the color list, there are some blends in this design, so I pulled out what I had done, which is really only this orange here, and I restarted. So I really only pulled out like 6 stitches, not a big deal, but and then I maybe did a total of 20 stitches and went to bed. So I'm gonna try and get a little work done on this tonight. A little tired. I just tried to indulge in a glass of wine while I was taking my post-work shower, which was very foolish. I'm a big fan of shower beer, if you guys are familiar. But shower wine, you know, I mean, I'm happy to say the wine glass survived, but I got red wine all over my freaking bathroom, and like, I'm not positive I got it all cleaned up. So, yeah. That's what happens when you try and put the relaxation on fast speed, I guess. Anyway, I'm gonna try and get a few stitches into this tonight. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Oh, there, the coverage is starting. So, what day is it? It's Wednesday. It's 11 o'clock. Lola and I getting ready to watch Team Canada take on Team USA in women's hockey. Prompt for today is something related to number 79. So I'm going to try and get 79 stitches here into Gingerbread Cat. I realize that a lot of days I've been showing you the start of a project but not the end, so sorry. I think what I'll do when I edit this video together is try and insert pictures of the final state of a project, you know, after the video clip, which is the last time I worked on it, if that makes sense. So you guys can see. But anyway, I have to be awake at 5 a.m. And I would really like to watch this entire hockey game and get 79 stitches in, but it's entirely possible I will fall asleep before the puck drops, which would be tragic, but I'm going to try. Anyway, fabric has some nice sparkle, right? This is a silk weaver. This is Weigart gingerbread. The colorway is gingerbread, and it's opalescent. A little loopy, if you can't tell. Anyway, see you later or tomorrow. Well, I got my 79 stitches in. And I'm going to tag out and go to bed. First period is over. It's 1-0 United States. So maybe I'm bad luck. So I'm going to go to sleep and hope for the best. Hello. It is Thursday night. I'm staying overnight tonight for work in a Holiday Inn.
typical hotel room. It has a nice chair, bed, chair, lampy kind of, sorry, I'm probably making you nauseous, area to stitch in. Prompt for today is something international. Heater just kicked on. So I'm going to stitch on my Beatrix Potter sampler, because, you know, she's British, was British. This is where I'm at. It's another Yearbooks project. So I'm going to throw it on the Q-snap now and see what I can do. I might get interrupted by some colleagues. But anyway, we'll see. You know, I remembered my Q-snap and my Grime Guard. Did not remember the snaps for the Q-snap. So, luckily I have a hoop here for another project. My first project has a hoop, so I can use that. But I'm a little annoyed with myself because I prefer Q-snap. But, oh well, it's one night. I can get by. So it is Sunday. I am playing catch up. A little bit. I was not able to. I stitched on my lunchtime project on Friday, but I wasn't able to stitch on any Olympics projects on Friday, so I caught up a little yesterday. And yesterday I was working on Friday's prompt, which was something with the letter P or C, so I was working on Gingerbread Cat, and today I decided just to do 100 more stitches on it before moving on to the next project to complete my monthly goal for it, and I just discovered all of this is off by one stitch. This is the page edge, and this is the page edge. So all of this, luckily, it's this part that's off and not the bottom. I mean, I guess they're off in relation to each other, but I'm gonna frog this section here, which is annoying. And then I'm going to put in 100 more stitches on this and put it away because I'm mad. Pretty mad. These are cookies here. You can kind of, if you know they're cookies, you can see that they're like thumbprint cookies. But still kind of just looks like blobs. This is like 400 stitches into this project, and
I bet this is 100 here that I'm about to pull out. And I'll try and,
I don't know. It's the worst, right? And I already frogged a whole bunch over here that I had put in that was wrong. So I might have to grid this project. I've never done any gridding before, but I've already done more frogging today than stitching, so maybe it's time to learn. So, restitched all this here, only to find this pink stuff
is again in the wrong spot and should be
one stitch down. All this stuff here. So, I'm gonna put this project away for a couple months because I'm over it.
Okay, so I took a break and did some things and got a manicure and, you know, recovered from my cross-stitch frustration. And
for the last prompt for Saturday and today, the prompt for Saturday was something new to you. And so this project, you saw this earlier. This is the first time I bought a pattern at a thrift store. It's the first time I actually bought a partially completed project that somebody else started at a thrift store. Only time, actually. And this was also the first time I had fabric custom dyed. The first and only time I've had fabric custom dyed for me. This is Silkweaver's Sudden Storm, but, when I ordered it, I had them dye me a piece with as little white as possible. So there's still a little white throughout, but it's much less than it normally is on there, in this color. And also the prompt for Sunday today, closing ceremonies, something close to finished. This obviously isn't close to finished, but I am close to my goal for the month, which was to get 500 stitches into this. I have 140 stitches left to go before I hit that goal. So I'm going to try and get those done this evening. And the call, you know, the snow color, the call for color is ecru. But I'm going to,
I don't know.
This looks a little yellow to me, so I think I'm going to switch it out for blah. But anyway, thanks for sticking it out with me. I really enjoyed this vlogging process. I might do it again if this cuts all together. I think we did pretty well in the Olympics. We ended up with like 30 medals, I think. 29 maybe, we being Canada, so a bit disappointing to not get any hockey golds, but a silver and a bronze isn't really a whole lot to complain about, and a few bummers in the curling area, I guess, right? But, you know, I think all in all successful. Yeah, I hope you guys had a successful, I don't know. I mean, I hope you guys enjoyed your Olympic fever as much as I did. I'm ready to go back to watching FlossTube. all the time instead of watching the Olympics all the time. Now I have 254 videos to catch up on because I watched zero FlossTube during the Olympics because I was Olympicking. Anyway, I'm rambling now, so thanks, and I will catch you guys sometime in the next couple weeks with a regular update. Maybe sometime in the first week of March. Bye!